is my Lord, birth after birth.
And maybe one of Priyaji can read the Bengali part, maybe today also. Your Bengali is beautiful.
You revealed divine knowledge within my heart. From him, ecstatic, loving devotion emanates. He destroys all ignorance, and his glories are sung by the Vedas. Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Pada's Tika. Divine knowledge. Although the living entity, who is Krishna's eternal servant, consists of pure spirit, he has forgotten his constitutional position and has been in the grip of the Lord's external illusory energy since beginningless time. Thus, he considers his gross material body to be himself, I, and his relationships, like wife and children, to be his mine. Thus, according to his cravings and his conditionings, he wears different bodies and wanders around in the material world, suffering the intolerable pangs of birth, death, old age, and disease.
Wow.
Worshipping Sri Krishna under the shelter of the lotus feet of Sri Guru is the only means to become free from this misery.
Wow.
The living entity has forgotten that he is Krishna's eternal servant due to this fault. Maya has bound him around the neck. If he worships Krishna and serves the Guru, the network of illusion will snap and he will attain Krishna's lotus feet. By giving initiation and instructions, Sri Gurudev will save the student from the ocean of birth and death. Opening his deluded physical eyes that are unable to perceive Godhead, and making them qualified to perceive spiritual things, thus blessing the disciple with the ambrosial relish of bhajan.
Read all of this yesterday, but no problem, repeating.
Yeah, we read it, but it's okay.
Here, along with the eyes, it is indicated that the other senses of the practitioner also become spiritualized and are made suitable for worshiping the Lord. The purport of this is that mundane senses and minds are unfit to worship Sri Krishna. When Sri Gurudev gives initiation mantra, being subdued by feelings of causeless compassion the disciple exclaims, "Oh, Sri Guru, oh, embodiment of the Lord's deep compassion, save me, who am scorched by the fire of material existence and grabbed by the force of time. O Lord, I am surrendered unto you." When the disciple exclaims this and surrenders his body, mind, and life airs to Sri Gurudev, then the Guru, with his touch of the power of the ambrosial principle of Godhead, anointed with his own compassion, which acts like a touchstone that turns iron into gold, along with the power of his own devotion, filled with his worship of the Lord, infuses devotion into the body, mind, and life airs of the disciple, thus making the disciple's body and senses qualified for the transcendental devotional service of the Lord's lotus feet. The body, mind, and senses of the sadhaka have thus become spiritualized and merged into worship of the Lord. And only by Guru's grace can it be accomplished that this stays in every limb of the body. In this way, Guru's grace will make the body and mind of the disciple suitable for the worship of the lotus feet, offers them to the Lord's lotus feet, and establishes a specific relationship of the living entity with the Lord. Hence, Srila Thakura Mahashaya says, "Chakshu dan dilo je janme jame prabhu se divya gyana hride prakashito." He opened my physical eyes and enabled me to perceive the principle of Godhead by opening them and turning them into devotional eyes, into devotional eyes anointed with the ointment of love. When he is pleased and places the power of his grace in the heart, divine knowledge is revealed there through his instructions and initiation into Krishna mantra. This Sri Guru, the bestower of love for Krishna and knowledge about him, is my Lord and Master, birth after birth, and I am his servant, birth after birth. This statement shows the relationship between the Guru and the disciple, and the eternity of that relationship also. In other words, a living entity wanders through the different species of life according to his previous activities and has relationships with different fathers, mothers, friends, and relatives each time. But the relationship between the guru and the disciple is not like that. Birth after birth, the disciple stays with the same Sri Guru according to the time, making him drink the sweet nectar of his bhajan, blessing him with prema, taking him to the kingdom of Leela, and ultimately blessing him by giving him the service of his beloved deity. Aho Guru Kripa! Nothing can equal this!
So this is it. So this verse is very interesting. Baba said, Shri Guru is my Lord and Master, birth after birth. I am his servant, birth after birth. This statement shows the relationship between the Guru and disciple and the eternity of that relationship also. That if we think only Sadhaka Deha, we cannot understand this verse. So, this should be spiritual Siddha Rupa relationship. And also, this verse says, Chakshudana Diroe Jame Jame Pabse. So Chakshudana, so opening his deluded physical eyes that are unable to perceive Godhead, making them qualified to perceive spiritual things. That blessing the disciple with the ambitious relation bhajan. I don't understand before, but now in this real meaning, Chakshudana Diroe means this. Gurudev give us spiritual vision, means Swarupa Besh also. In the Swarupa Besh, we can perceive Godhead and our Swamini. So this verse actually indirectly mentioned we have Sadhaka Deha and Siddha Deha. And Gurudev's mission is to open the eye, to open the kind of Swarupa Besha. Because Sadhaka Deha, only Sadhaka Deha is imperfect. Because in this Sadhaka Deha, we cannot enter the spiritual world. So we are chanting every day, or maybe many days. But this actually very deep meaning, I feel it. Especially this eternal relationship with Gurudev. Many people asking, what do you mean this eternal relationship? And if someone who is practicing Vaidhi Bhakti, it is difficult to explain. That's my feeling.
You want to comment?
I don't just have
to say, support what you told. When I was in Gaudimat, they explained these words, Janma Prabhu said means, Nityananda, Akanda Guru Tapa. He will take care about you, know about Swarupa Matra, know relationship in eternity. And it means, now this Vaishnava taking care about you, then other Vaishnava taking care, will take care about you. Nityananda, the original Guru, Janma Prabhu. They explained this way.
Beautiful.
Of course, you know, of course, Nita is original Guru. Of course, Nita is take care, and without Nita's mercy, we cannot attain Gora, we cannot attain Radha Mohan, that is sure. But he has mentioned that. Eternity of the relationship also. So Guru is eternity and disciple also eternity. And also relationship also eternity. So this is not, could not explain nicely, I feel.
The mother, he is using two interesting phrases, main event in life and main event in eternity.
Oh.
It doesn't mean when disciple receiving mercy from Shiguru, receiving his Siddhaswarup. Oh, for him it means main event in life when he met such guru. But when he is receiving Swarup of Srimati Radhika in this relationship, he is main even in eternity. When he is receiving position of Radha Dasa.
Yeah, I agree also. I also think same thing. Because without this one, then we can again born material life. We continuously suffer, you know, three kinds of misery and birth, disease, and old age and death. So this is main event, also greatest mercy upon us.
After this, Srila Thakura Mahasaya says, Prema Bhakti Jahoite Avidya Vinashajati Vedega Jahara Charito. We have said that when the compassion of the Lord, who is an ocean of mercy, becomes very dense, it assumes a tangible form and appears as the guru to benefit the conditioned souls.
So this also very interesting. So if we say, Guru Devi say, our feeling become very condensed. Greed, if we appear greed, then our spiritual feeling become intense. Then we can get spiritual body also. So this also from beginning, some candidate, some desire is coming. You know, like who am I, why I'm suffering, what's the aim of life, kind of this. Further relations, kind of sambandha abhideya, prayojana. Some kind of question appear in the sadhaka or kind of candidate. then that feeling becomes very intense, dense. Then that the Krishna send some form as Sri Gurudev to benefit and to save the conditions. So that's, you know, very interesting. But if we are not interested, if Gurudev appear, but they are not conscious, they are not understand. The next verse is very, you know, very interesting sentence. Next verse.
Through that, Sri Gurudeva, who is the incarnation of the Lord's grace, we can come to know the Lord's compassion. Sri Gurudev's heart is the jeweled throne where Queen Bhakti, who is the essence of the Lord's pleasure and existence potencies, sits. Sri Gurudev's heart is the jeweled throne where Queen Bhakti, who is the essence of the Lord's pleasure and existence potencies, sits. Sitting there, she distributes her grace to the people of the world. Mounting Sri Guru's grace, she pervades the heart of the student and blesses him with the gift of prema.
So this is also very interesting. So why Gurudev is the incarnation of the Lord's grace? Somebody may ask questions. My answer is like this. Krishna is enjoyer. So he does not enough time to take care of the devotees, because his main thing is to enjoy. But Gurudev experienced this material world. So Gurudev knows how conditioned soul is suffering. But Krishna may not know. Like, say, big company, some CEO there. CEO, like a president of company. Especially this CEO come from like a family of, you know, founders. So he may not know how ordinary workers feeling, how ordinary worker is suffering or facing difficulty. CEO may not know this, or may know, but may not know. But someone who experience ordinary worker and then get some position, like a manager or somebody, that person know the heart and the feeling of workers, because he also experienced. So that manager who knows the heart of worker can be more merciful. Sometimes I was working one company, but the son or daughter of founders, they don't understand what worker is feeling. So similarly, so Krishna is like an enjoyer. So Krishna may not enough time to take care, or may not perceive the feeling. So therefore, if someone who is sincere, Krishna or Radharani send the representative, then he asks them, please take care. So therefore, Gurudev has so much compassion. And also here mentioned, Gurudev's heart is jeweled throne where Queen Bhakti. So this Queen Bhakti also this is incarnation like Radhika. And this Queen Bhakti sitting the jewel throne like Ratana Shinhasana. And this, who is the essence of Lord's pleasure and existence potency? See? This is my understanding. This pleasure potency is Radha. Existence potency is actually Sandini and Gurudev.
It's in English, existing potency. There's two potencies.
Yeah.
Sandini potency.
Sandini and Pradini. Is it correct?
No, I'm just trying to check because in Russian it's a little
different. Okay. So, means. So Gurudev, this is my feeling. Gurudev's is two aspects. Is the essence of Lord Flagini Shakti means Shri Guru Radha Dasi. Also this existence potency represent of Guru Tattva. Existence potency, like
second aspect of
the good. So means like a mitai. So means mitai aspect because Guru Tattva. Also Guru Tattva, especially Shri Guru. It's rather dancing aspect, especially this our Sampradaya, this Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, our Sampradaya. Because Mahaprabhu teaching us this Unnato Jvararasa, means Baba Urasa, Radharajini feeling. Who knows Radharajini feeling? This Radharaji. So Radha Dasi knows and Radha's feeling, also Krishna's feeling. And so we have read before one new Manjari brought in front of Rupa Manjari. Then Rupa Manjari was saying to Radharani, "Oh, hey Radhika, I brought a very nice new Manjari. This from Manjulari Manjari. This new Manjari Narottam Dasa. So this is so nice, kind-hearted, very gentle, very nice, so please accept." Then Radhani said, "Oh, if you say like this, yes, I'll accept like this." So I feel this Gurudev's heart So Bhakti is sitting. Bhakti Devi is sitting. For us, it's easy to understand our radical sitting. And Gurudev said, if Radhika only stay in Braja, if go outside Braja, Radhika become Anangamajai. This is Nitai also. So this is so, this two aspects, this is very interesting for me.
When knowledge about the relationship with God is attained by Sri Guru's grace, all possessiveness towards bodily things and matters that are not related to Krishna is lost. And through the Sri Guru Pranali, a deep possessiveness towards Sri Krishna descends to the heart of the practitioner, like the stream of the heavenly Ganga, causing loving devotion to awaken within it. This confidential principle can be learned from Srimad Bhagavatam. So now we do the verse from Bhagavatam. And Sridhar Swami's Tika. Brahma and other gods prayed to Sri Krishna while he was in Devaki Devi's womb. O self-luminous one, your grace towards the devotees is limitless. On the strength of your grace, the devotees take shelter of the boat of your lotus feet and cross over the ocean of material existence, which is otherwise hard to cross. These devotees, in their turn, are so kind towards the conditioned souls that they keep this boat of your lotus feet in the form of the devotional tradition, Sri Guru Parampara, succession, in this material world for their redemption. From this it is clearly understood that there is no other means to cross over the ocean of material existence and to attain loving devotion than to take shelter of Sri Guru's lotus feet. The main result of taking shelter of Sri Guru's lotus feet is the attainment of Prema and the service of the lotus feet of the Lord. While a concomitant factor is the destruction of ignorance, which lies root at material existence, which lies at the root of material existence. Hence, Śrīla Thakura Mahāśāya says, avidyā vināśa jāte, through the Lord's external energy, maya, ignorance, the living entities have forgotten their own constitutional position, having been averse to the Lord since beginningless time. This ignorance is of five kinds: tama, moha, mahamoha, tamishra, and adha tamishra. Tama means ignorance, in the sense that in deep darkness you cannot even see your own hand when you stretch it out, not to speak of anything else. Similarly, if the conditioned soul cannot even understand his own constitutional position, then how can he ever see Sri Krishna? As long as this ignorance or tama remains. Moha means having no idea what to do and what not to do. Maha moha means desire for enjoyment. Tamishra means anger arising from thwarted enjoyment. Thwarted means prevented, thwarted means there's obstacle, that you can't enjoy, there's something blocking your enjoyment. Thwarted means blocked.
I see.
And adha tamishra means absorption in protecting one's enjoyment when it is under threat of an extinction.
It's not clear, sorry. Yeah. What's the last phrase?
So it's just described, it's explaining these terms, these Sanskrit words. Yeah. So moha, moha means... Antha tamishra means absorption, means total engrossment, total immersion, total obsession with, or you're totally deep into something, right? Absorption. Yeah. Absorption in protecting one's enjoyment when that enjoyment is under threat of extinction. So extinction means, you know, being annihilated, being destroyed. Yeah. These kinds of ignorance are the work of Maya. By the grace of Sri Guru, this ignorance is destroyed as a concomitant consequence. So, in other words, the main result is to attain the loving devotion. This is the main goal, right? The main effect, the main result of Guru's grace is to attain loving devotion of the Lord. But there's a concomitant result, means...
Side effect.
Exactly, it's like a side effect. It happens also. It's not the main thing, but it's important. And it's also happening. And this is destroying all of these five, what they call ignorance, five kinds of ignorance. Mm-hmm. So in the verse it says, avidya is ignorance, vinasha Okay, so removing, destroying the ignorance, these five kinds of ignorance, which he described as karma, darkness meaning, he's given an example, we can't even see our hands, so we don't know what is our constitutional position, we're in the dark, ignorant of who we are, you know, that we're in this ignorance, and so on and so forth. So these are concomitant, these are not the main goals, but this is happening automatically. So concomitantly means simultaneously or concurrently, you can also say. Concurrently means at the same time. Another meaning of avidya is the different vices that form obstacles that the practitioner faces in bhaja. Vice means like a bad habit, like something.
He gave reason to see what is good for me, what is bad for me, what is right and what is wrong for me. Is not sufficient, then he do Dibya Gyan Hridaya Prakasha. Because it's not very sufficient to be giving one divine eyes to me, third eyes. Two eyes I have, one more eyes. Any time ignorance can catch me. Then what he do? Dibya Gyan. He Chakshudan Dilo. He gave the Chakshudan and he Dibya Gyan. He enlightened with the Dibya, divine Hridaya Prakash. He enlightened to me in heart what is a Dibya, divine knowledge. When I will listen, then I will understand. We don't listen. That is not I surrender. I listen, but I throw it out. Forty years before, what happened with me and Gurudev, still I remember. And I am living in that his teaching. They began his Prakasha.
So Gurudev, what is the teaching? Your Gurudev is teaching.
Why I would say everything? What he teach me, I love it. I don't read books, you see. But read book, I will explain it. Because he gilok, he Dibya Gyan Hridaya Prakasha. Means if I read, I don't believe in his word. I never read. But from my beginning, when I took sannyas, I don't know. Honestly. And that moment I cannot read because Paramadvaiti Maharaj gave me a Spanish book. A Spanish book.
Oh.
Of Sridhar Maharaj. I cannot read. I said, well, I don't know Spanish reading and understanding. One translator will be there. He will translate. So I'm listening. And I listen that what is true is what Sridhar Maharaj book, not
any other book. You know how beautiful book of his books. You cannot understand if you are not in Sarupavesh. You cannot understand his book. You read and you not, if you're not in Sarupavesh, you read like something. And when my Sarupavesh was that, that was my sadhana to be in Sarupavesh. To understand that. And by listening, I explain that book, everybody likes it. And I say in English and they translate again in Spanish. I don't know what they translate. I have no idea. But 9 months I went in this process. So, Gurudev teaching, if you not accept, your eyes is not chakshudan, not yet. They began it there. How it will go in if the ear is not listening? Eye has to talk. Ear has to drink. Eyes can talk. Ear can drink. You can give water inside. It can drink. But yes, eyes has to talk when the tears come from the eyes. This is talking of the eyes. And ear is drinking when you listen and put in your heart, that is drinking. You use in your life, that's a drinking. Chakshu dan diloje. Janme janme pramuse. Who gives me eyes? Who enlightens me? And I do not believe him. Janme janme pramuse. I don't believe that I am foolish. I am searching other place. I am a fool. Janme janme Prabhu Sri. So many life he gave me. He want to enlighten me, but I am not ready to accept his eyes. And somebody accept. His enlightenment will come in 1 minute. It not takes long time. How many philosophy Krishna book read Uddhava? So many. What happened to him? Chakshudan Diloji. He understand divine vision. And his heart was Dipigyan. Is a cover to what he talk is a divine. This is the point. It's not no long process. One point it goes and you accept Janme, Janme, Prabhu say. He is my life and life taking. You will not believe me. All of you, I see my Gurudev expansion. Why I give Dandavat and Dushis? Because I see my Gurudev is teaching through you. This is Chakshudan. This is the reason he gave to see every living being that he will teach you. I am expanded in all every living being. This is Chakshudan. And you know, after this vision, you need a Dibya Gyan. You need Dibya Vision. And he knows only Krishna can give this divine vision. Then he understands, no, it will not work more. Then he says, Prema Bhakti Jaha Hoite. Without mercy of Radhika, Prema will not come to you. Love will not come. So you need Prema. Radhika's mercy. Dibya Gyan is up to Krishna. All divinity and his information will come. When your high heart will cover with Dibya. All details will reveal to you. So many lives you study, all will come out. Because heart is divine now. There is no any corner with impurity. They began. Then it will not work. Then he said, Prema Bhakti Jaha Hoite. When the mercy of Radha will come, then your Dibya Gyan will work. All ignorance automatic will go when you will know to be a servant of Radhika, to always live with her. That is Prema. What is meaning of Prema? Out of Radhika? Prema Bhakti. Nobody Bhakti. Prema Bhakti Jaha Bhakti. Radha Bhakti Jaha Bhakti. Avidya, all ignorance, all foolishness, all covering will out. Hare Narottam Das Thakur said, I am not telling Veda Gaye Jaharo Charitra. All Vedas, all literature, all scriptures are telling this. So what is to do? Listen of Rasika and make it in life, not doubt it. Yeah. That is reason. And believe in Krishna. He is a divine. Why doubt? Accept it, sign it. Prabhupada said, divine covering come, but it will not work. Prema Bhakti Jaha Hoite. Avidya Vinashaya. All ignorance will go out when Prema will come. Radhika will come to you. You will know this divine is searching that love. I have to be a servant of Radhika to serve this divine, to make happy to my Swami Prema, who is Alladini Shakti, Prema Rupini, Anandamai, Rasmai. What is his many names? That Prema. That the thing. Nothing more to do. This is the conclusion of the all scripture. Of how much time we take, 1 second, 1 minute, one life, two life, three lives. That depends. When I will understand this. If too much covering and blockage is there, created by us, then takes time. And when the mercy has to come, then Chakshudan. And Dibhigyan can clean everything. Chakshudan means you have to believe. We have to see it. Why not seeing? What he is telling, you have to feel, see it. Because your cover, eyes is very material cover. You don't believe, don't see it. Right?
Yes.
Huh? Yes. See it. Then Gurudev said, oh no, eyes giving will not work. Dibhigyan is a process. Heart is very stone. It has, hridaya has to be soft. It has to be clean. Has to be washed nicely. Softness is not keeping, not accepting. Hridaya prakashita, have to enlight. They create darkness again and again. Dibhigyan, hridaya prakashita. Hridaya means heart prakashita. And when dibhigyan, hridaya prakashita, then prema can come, prema bhakti, Without this, what is meaning of Karnagati? Listen and see that and note it. No need to forget this, live in that, then realize itself. God in your heart. Heart will be divine. Record in mind, mind will be divine. Where you will record, it will become divine. Long time. Not take a long time. And that's a Sarnagat. How much I'm loyal to understanding that. That is Sarnagat. Loyal to accept that. That is something. Not externally to do something. eloquence who is teaching how much you accept in life. That is service.
Completely understand what you mean externally, not do something externally, but to accept something for the essence for my
right.
Yeah.
Outside showing is no. I was in Anandas Babaji, sitting always with him. His disciple come and give dandavat and go. Give dandavat and go. Not seed, no clean, no dvajik, the clothes, nothing. But when I find out about his life, totally following his instruction, totally follow his teaching in his life, 100%, living with that. Because no time out what he is saying, from there no time how he will give other place time. This is Sanaya. This is Prema, Raga Bhakti, Abhaiti Bhakti, I don't know. I never practice, I have no experience from that. In life, I never practice.
Yes, sir.
My Gurudev asks, what you mean? I say, Prema Bhakti. I don't interested in wedding. I don't want to. What activities is happening? It looks like a wedding. But it's all Raghavata in my temple. We never press anyone to do this. We never said this. And what is happening from your feeling, that is Prema. Under pressure, what you have to do, that is Bhakti. The big hand will come, you will see Krishna. Prema will come, you will see Radha. Because she is the giver of Prema. How much your consciousness will grow, you will find there to your yesterday. If he is under unconsciousness is there, we will find outside. Depends. Who is the best judge? I am the best judge for myself. That is consciousness. Right or not? How I will know unconsciousness and consciousness, if I cannot judge myself. If I am not conscious and I don't have a consciousness, how I can develop consciousness to you? And that here, I have to judge my, I have to judge yours. Right or not?
Right.
How Guru can judge? These are all false. And Sarnagati means what I listen and adopt in my practice. That is Sarnagati. Listening and not listening, not listening and bring in my life. Uddhavji?
Sometimes they compare the guru to a fire, no? And the devotees, they are like iron. So we have to keep into the fire to become like a fire. Then iron can become like a fire.
Yes. That means I'm ready to digest. I'm ready to more and more to receive more faster. How much? You have association with your spiritual master, your progress will be more faster. Because when and where mercy will flow, you don't know. Knowing one thing and realization is other thing. I know something. But by his deep association, he makes you to realize us. That's the beauty. He makes you to realize, believe this fact. And without realization, that is not my subject. When I will realize it, it will be my subject. The beauty, not knowing only, to realize it. So, how to realize it? We need three things. Vision, clean heart, divine heart, divine knowledge to cover my heart. And third, it's Prema, radha. So divine is Krishna and Prema is Radha. So what you have, all is with you. It's so simple. Why you make complications?
Gurudev, is this Maha Mantra? Radha and Krishna.
Maha Mantra is Maha Mantra. Maha Mantra is not comparison with this. Maha Mantra is a prayojan of our life. You cannot comparison with anything to Maha Mantra. It's a prayojan. Prayojan means living in that. Maha Mantra. If you cannot live, you cannot be conscious. Your vision, eyes will not judge you. You not receive the divine eyes. You cannot see what is Maha Mantra. I explained so many times. That vision to see that Maha Mantra from eyes, that is divine eyes. to live in that consciousness, in Mahamantra, that is Dibhyan Hrithe Prakashita. Living in that circle and to feel the prema of Radhika, how she is rushingly embrace Krishna and want to give everything to Krishna. This gives Mahamantra to live in that process. How maximum you can give time to live there, that is Mahamantra. How much you have a time to clean and enlighten your heart, that is Mahamantra. Not make much complication, so easy like this. So simple, so easy. Mahajan, make it in our life. So,
Gurudev, can I ask something?
Sure.
I'm not sure if I understand what you said. For realization, we need three things. Vision, is this?
Right.
Is vision?
Vision means I can see it. I'm not blind.
Yes.
That is vision.
And does that mean?
My vision was not I can see because my cataract. My vision was you are sitting, I cannot see you. When I make the operation, I got again my vision. I can see everything. So this vision, Dibhyan, this divine vision, Chakshudan Dirde, he give me again divine vision that I can check right and wrong. I can calculate. I learned this to calculate. This will give you suffering, this will give you good thing, what you want. Then Dibhyan Hrithe Prakashita. So he made my heart also only to meditate divine things. Why material? You not know about suffering? You not suffer before? Why not you protect more to suffer? See the divinity. No sastra is stopping you to do sex or not go to doctor and not go do pee-pee. It's a natural phenomena. But not live in the toilet sitting. Do your job and come out. My whole life I will make the AC room inside and toilet and golden tap and this and that. To live and make the bed there. Where is the rich in this? But if I have a pressure, I will hold it. One time I went to toilet, it was very nice subject was there. I said, I asked myself, why not hold some more time to listen that? I said, no. If you hold it, you cannot listen. My pressure is very high. So you clean it, then you can listen. I say, you see, this is thing. If you have a pressure, clean it.
But no sleep on the toilet.
Not sleep in the toilet. Not think for the toilet.
Finish.
Everything is teaching Chaitanya Guru to me. And if there is no pressure, then what you will do? When I was a young man, then I think that when I will old, then I will control my senses and then I can vanish. I am so young, so I cannot control it. Now I become old. Now my senses are all more uncontrolled than before. Before I can hold it half an hour, but now I cannot hold half an hour. I have to run quick. You see? So is it wrong that you can control it for it? I smile myself. What happened? You want to control your senses? Why are you running for pee? No control. So do now. Don't waste your time. Now. That is the spiritual life. Not keep for the old age or after 1 year or next day.
Manana,
no. Now. Really is now.
What's the third point? Vision?
Prema.
Dibya Gyan. Always connected with Divine. And who's Divine?
Krishna.
Only one.
Krishna.
He is the Divine. Many say Paramatma. But Paramatma, Bhagavan and Brahma, they all three are one. So we believe in Bhagavan. Bhagavan means Krishna. We believe in the form because I want to develop relation with you. I want to see your exchange of love. I want to see you in form, not in without form. Without form is the light, is spark of the light. I want to be with the love. Lover can not love, you cannot love without form. So my Radha want to love. So she needs the form. So I need your form to see, to bring to her. No? Form, I want to be, to see you form, not in light. Jesus wants to see his Father in the form. Jesus wants to see Mother Mary in the motherly form.
What does that mean? Because she is my Ishtadev, and then I have to be connected with Krishna?
Why not? He is the lover of my Ishtadev. Lover? First I have to request him to go to Radhika without purity of me. She will not allow me to go there. Divine will not allow me to go to see her beloved. Why? We have to come in the Divine consciousness. Like a body is living when the soul is dead. Right? When the soul go out from the body, this body will go to, what is it?
Crematory.
Or graveyard. Because soul is not there. Similarly, soul has a body. By the grace of Prema. To love. Right? Soul gives body. Soul has a given body by through the Prema. Not with divine. Prema give body to love. To see her love. And this body given by Prema, soul is radha. So without becoming this purity, how we can serve to Prema? This purity has to come to serve Prema. Krishna need one step only, to know your soul. But to serve Radhika, one step more higher. Prema has a body. Prema give body to the soul. This soul. And this body has a soul, that is Radha. So my body is of the soul. Is not material. My soul has a body. Given, this body is giving by Radhika, Prema. So how divine is this? Higher than Krishna. To feel that love of divine couple. So how we can calculate with material eyes? Possible?
No.
Then I don't understand. No, I cannot explain to them. Can you explain to them? They don't understand. Can you? Somebody explain. They are worried. They don't know.
Yeah, I have a question now about.
No, see, they will explain. My English is not very I cannot explain very nicely.
My English is not good to understand very nicely. Sorry.
Can you explain in German to them?
What good?
German, then.
Good idea. Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. Come here.
In German?
Yeah.
I translate or I explain, Guruji?
He will say you. Somebody will say you. Yes. Can you go backside very good to repeat and understand this. Simple. Make complicated. Not complicated. Yes, Uddha? Simple, no? Yes.
Maybe you can repeat the question.
Yes, can you repeat the question?
You want to explain? You explain.
Yes.
Buddha will explain.
Yes, very nice.
He is very clear.
Yes.
Yeah? Question? The question is why we have to surrender to Krishna if our Ishtadev is Radhika actually?
Yes.
Krishna is the foundation for soul consciousness, whereas Radhika is the foundation for the next step higher, which is love. That's the short answer.
More explained.
Maybe I can add something.
In German, maybe a little bit?
Yes, both. Maybe first English, then Gurudev can say if this is right.
Yeah.
The spiritual body, it's a prakriti deha. So it means it needs to be enjoyed by Krishna. So Radhika is giving this body, but we are serving to Radhika, but Radhika is not doing anything for herself. She's doing for the pleasure of Krishna. So we are also serving to Krishna. It's not that we are only serving to Radhika. By our service, we want to also please to Krishna. Not directly, but this is the wish of Radhika, no? To serve to Krishna.
What was your first one?
Prakriti deha, Gurudev. Like the spiritual body is a, to be enjoyed, no? Not we are enjoying there. Or what are you saying?
No, only soul consciousness.
Mm.
Is Krishna, we see super soul.
Yes.
When we know the soul, we see super soul.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
But she is just asking that you are Radha devotee, you
yes.
say.
Yes.
Then why Krishna is coming?
Yeah.
Right? So Krishna is coming to be a conscious.
Mm-hmm.
By the soul, not your body.
Yes.
You move from this bodily identification, ego identification, to move to the soul.
Right, right, right.
And when you will come to soul, you will be connected with Krishna because of the soul. Then Krishna says, you are not right place. You want to know my knowledge about me, or you want to love me?
So zuerst connecten wir uns mit Krishna, weil wir müssen zuerst in unser Seelenbewusstsein kommen. Und die Seele, die hat noch keine Beziehung sozusagen. Die ist ein Tadasta Shakti, ne? Soul ist Tadasta Shakti.
Yeah.
Die ändert oft die Stimmung. Also die hat eine Verbindung mit Krishna, weil sie auch von Krishna kommt, die Seele. Und Krishna sagt dann, weiterzugehen, zur Radhika, zur Liebe.
Es gibt verschiedene Arten und Weise, eine Beziehung zu Krishna zu haben.
Mhm.
In unserer Tradition ist es durch Radhika. Mhm. Zuerst Seelebewusstsein mit Krishna und dann weiter durch unsere Relation zu
English
also. Mm-hmm. There are many different ways and traditions of relating to Krishna, who's God and the Creator. In our tradition, we seek a loving relation to Krishna, and this comes through Radhika.
So we want to take shelter of Radhika to feel their love. Feel divine love. Not I'm interested to relate. I want to be with her to learn how the conjugal lover divine
is. Dass ich mich mit ihm verbinde. Ich möchte sehen, wie sie, was für ein Austausch, dass sie haben miteinander, Radha und Krishna.
And like us, we have a material body.
Wir haben einen materiellen Körper.
We have to come out from this false ego.
Wir müssen raus aus dem falschen Ego.
Well, this material body is a tendency of enjoyment.
Mit diesem Körper haben wir immer Verlangen zu genießen.
So I leave this Living in this material body, I want to go out from this consciousness. This is the
beginning.
I want to be in the soul consciousness. That is Prakriti Deha.
Das ist ein Prakriti Deha.
Divine body.
Ein transzendentaler Körper.
This is Purusha Deha.
Und das hier Purusha. Ist ein Purusha Deha. Ein Purusha ist ein Genießer.
But Adi Purusha is only Krishna.
Der einzige Genießer ist eigentlich Krishna. Aber dieser Körper ist auch ein Genießer. Der materielle Körper.
So Sadhak, Sadhak Bhakta, who say I am Adi Bhakta, they live in Purusha-Abhimana.
So die Vaidhi-Bhakti praktizieren, die leben in ihrem Genießerkörper.
They misuse their consciousness. They want to be Adi-Purusha, means they want to be Krishna himself to enjoy everything.
Die wollen dann selber Genießer sein. Und das bedeutet im Grunde, dass sie selber Krishna sein wollen.
The false ego bring up to here.
Und so weit kann ich das falsche Ego dann bringen, also völlig irregeführt.
And then, if I'm a preacher, I say I'm a preacher. And then, the preacher bringing to the false ego.
Und die Prediger, die das realisiert haben, die bringen dich dann auch nur ins falsche Ego.
Increasing the false ego.
This is Vaidhi Bhakta.
I'm a doer.
Ich bin der hier alles macht.
Are? I'm a viewer.
Na, das ist falsch. Ich bin nur am
Zuschauen. You are a doer.
Ihr seid alle die.
You both are doer. I'm a viewer. This consciousness only comes in Prakriti Deha, in spiritual body.
Vom spirituellen Körper, von unserem dienenden Körper, wie sehen wir, dass nur Radha und Krishna irgendwas machen. Wir machen gar nichts. Das ist alles ein Austausch von Radha und Krishna. Wir sind nur Zuschauer.
This is the point.
Das ist der Punkt.
Doer or viewer?
Wir sind Macher oder wir sind Schauer. That's a little funny word.
Yes. So, I want to be a doer. I don't want to be a viewer.
Ich möchte immer alles selber machen. Ich möchte nicht nur zuschauen.
Dann karta abhiman come and we come to bodily.
Das hält uns aber im körperlichen Bewusstsein.
I'm a doer.
Ich mache hier alles.
Ego, false ego say, yeah, you are a doer.
Und das falsche Ego, das sagt, ja, super, du bist hier der alles kontrolliert. Get
my kids, also, but just.
So, how to, she's asking how to, I'm only seeing Radhika Gurudev, so how to now
because
go to Krishna?
We want to see from my doer abhiman. That's not possible. Doer means bodily consciousness.
Wenn ich hier alles machen will, dann heißt es, ich bin körperbewusst.
We have to be
etwas kontrollieren.
Connected with my soul.
Aber wir müssen verbunden sein.
We have to come from doer consciousness in a viewer consciousness.
Wir müssen von dem, der hier irgendwas verändern will, ins Bewusstsein kommen, von dem, der hier einfach schaut.
Simple. Viewer consciousness is a Prakriti Deha.
Wenn wir anfangen, Sachen nur wahrzunehmen und sie nicht selber zu kontrollieren, dann bekommen wir diesen Prakriti Deha, unser Seelenbewusstsein.
Aber this Deha is an enjoyment Deha.
Dieser Körper von uns, der ist nur am Genießen.
We are female. But we think that we are male.
Wir sind vielleicht
how
in einem Frauenkörper, aber eigentlich ist dieser Körper, egal ob Mann oder Frau, immer Genießer und immer männlich, sozusagen.
This is aber. It's false ego.
Das ist das falsche Ego.
That is the reason to sleep. I explained, you have to practice it. Without practice, my old practice will uncover me.
Wenn wir nicht praktizieren, dann wird mein altes Verhalten mich immer wieder fangen.
And this I give you the vision.
Ich gebe euch jetzt eine
But at the beginning, Herr Prakash, you have to cover this with the divine consciousness. How you will cover, that you have to know. Gurudev show you Dibya Gyan Hirdaya Prakashita. Then Prema will come, Radha will appear. Understand, Radha Charan? This is the step. One, two, three. Third step. Prema means Radha.
Maybe one thing I can add that will maybe help to, because I see that you're like a little worried. Because one time Gurudev was sharing that why Radharani is there, why she's anyway there. So Radha Mohan is our Ishtadev and we want to be servants of Radhika, but what Radhika is doing. So Radhika actually is manifested from Krishna only to make Krishna happy, because he's the supreme enjoyer who wants to enjoy everything. So Radharani, Gurudev is saying that what he learned from his guru, from our Param Gurudev, was that the Antaranga Shakti becomes Bahiranga Shakti, means that Radharani actually, like from Krishna Radharani comes the inner energy, becomes outer energy, and so Radharani creates everything. So everything that exists, also our bodies and what we are doing, is all to serve Krishna, to make Krishna happy. And like Uddhava said, there are so many ways to relate to the Krishna. You can be a friend, you can be a mother. There are these relationships. And our relationship is to be the maidservant of Radharani. But it's still all to serve Krishna, because he's the Supreme Lord. And often it can be confusing, because Gurudev say, I don't want to listen to Krishna because Radharani, I am serving Radharani. But in the back of this, in the background, it's only to fix us more in our mood. But Radharani only wants to serve Krishna and make him happy. So this is also our goal.
Very good. Because you know, so Radha's Ishtadeva is Krishna. So Manjari's Ishtadeva is Radhika. But you know, to serve Radhika, we have to concern also Mohan, Krishna also. Otherwise, Radhika, we cannot serve.
Because if you want to serve Radhika, means you want to help her help make Krishna happy.
Yeah. Right.
Help her love Krishna.
So
that's to bring Krishna, that she can give more love. But we are not interested in like Rupi or Sakhi.
No.
That is the point. This is the beautiful you.
Very beautiful.
Yeah.
Very
beautiful. You see?
You see that? This is the beginning. Chakshudan, Jelodi, Janmai, Janmai, Prabhu say, you give me this vision. I'm trying to practice this.
Hmm.
Unko bhi toh
and Guru.
They began it at that prakash. And that way you show more details of that, how to love. That is the began. Prem bhakti jahavate, all of vidya vinashyate, vedekaye jahara charitra. All the scriptures are talking. Kire?
Baba.
Sati katha na?
Sati katha.
Tumi bangla bujo, tumake vyakha korte hobe. Ki karo tuma amake, kematan? Bujbo. Ki boltei hobe.
Apni shastre janen baba.
So prem bhakti Candrika. Padho, Narottam Prarthana padho. You know, nobody, sorry to say, not a god. Nobody